When an object is rendered into an image, at each pixel, the distance from the object to the camera is used to compute its z-depth, a value from 0 to 1. So here, for example, I've rendered a sphere, and at this pixel, I found that the depth of the sphere is 0.6. This value is then checked against the current value stored in the z-buffer, which you'll recall we've initialized to all 1s. If the object's distance is lower than the z-depth value stored, the object is closer to the camera, and so the color of the object is then stored in the image's color buffer. So in this case, the sphere's depth is clearly closer than the maximum value you can store in the z-depth, so it's visible at this point. Next, say we draw a cube. The cube's depth at this pixel is 0.3, which is closer than the 0.6 that we have stored for what the sphere did. So since it's closer, we use the cube's color at this pixel and replace this value. 0.3 replaces 0.6. Say the last object we draw is this ground plane. At the pixel, it turns out the ground plane's depth is 0.8. This is higher than the current z-depth, 0.3, so the ground plane fails, which is as it should be because the ground plane is obviously farther away than these two objects. The final conclusion of this process is that the current z-depth stays at 0.3, and the color that's stored at the pixel, this blue cube, is indeed the color that gets displayed on the screen. By storing a depth at each pixel, the GPU can mindlessly keep track of what object is closest at any given moment. What's interesting to realize is that decades ago, when this idea first came up of the z-buffer, it was considered absurdly expensive because you had to add a big chunk of memory of z-depth buffer that was just an outrageous amount. You'd have to add a whole megabyte of memory, which would be outrageously expensive. So this algorithm originally was a terrible idea, and memory costs came down just a tad, and it's now the predominant way of rasterizing triangles.